Hey, John, how you doing?
Good. How you doing?
Good. Through 9 games here in a Penn State uniform, you weren't available early in the season. You've had some injury stuff. What have you learned about yourself here in your last college campaign?
How to fight through adversity. My brothers, I see them battle. They all pick me up. We all pick each other up when some adversity strikes or whatever. So I always have my brothers behind me to keep me moving forward.
Has that been important in the running back room? You obviously have been
of course,
in the focus
yeah.
for the lack of production.
This team is like a family. Like, we can't get any closer. So everybody picks each other up, like I said, and they've been there for me, and I've been there for them. And thank you for them guys.
John, I know you're going to get a lot of questions about the running game proper, but how much have you guys emphasized the passing game and being there available as options in the passing game?
One more time.
How have you guys been focusing on, and how do you guys work into the passing game for Sean in situations where he needs to get a check down or something out in the front?
Just every day in practice, we do daily skill, things like that to get a stronger relationship and connection with the quarterback, wide receivers, running backs, everything like that. So we can just get on the same page in situations like that.
James said one of the keys to getting the offense even more effective is having more effective plays or more explosive plays from the running game. How close do you think you guys are, and what are some of the keys to getting that going?
We're getting really close. Our defense is helping us tremendously. As you guys know, we have one of the best defenses in the country. We battle with them every day. They're getting our guys up front better. They're getting us better as running backs, tight ends, wide receivers. So we're getting close.
What do you think the final pieces of that puzzle is?
Just go out there and do it. Just execute it. We're practicing these plays every day. Everything we need to do, just go out there and put it all together.
John, I know Michigan and Penn State is always a big game for the other guys that have been here before, but you know, how excited are you to be able to get your first and I guess only game in this rivalry?
I'm excited and I'm blessed to have an opportunity to come out this weekend and compete against another great team. So me and my brothers gonna go out here and do what we gotta do to go 1-0.
John, just going off that, obviously you guys preach going 1-0 every single week. You prepare the same for every single opponent. But how much does getting the win last week after a couple of, you know, rough games, how does that impact overall morale from the team?
We had a couple rough games where we just put those behind us because nothing we can do about it. Once it's over, it's over. So we focus on being 1-0 every single day. And we spend extra hours in this building just to become 1-0.
What is Jaywon Sider's approach after a rough game where you guys didn't live up to your expectations? How does he handle that on Sundays?
Jaywon, he's a great coach. He's aggressive. He's pushing all of us, details, every little thing. So if it's a step from running back, 6 inches this way or something like that, he's on top of everything. So all the details matter with Coach Sider.
What's the trust like in the running back room? And Noah talked to us after the game and last week about how much conversations of constructive criticism with Jaywon have gone. Well, what's the trust like with him and the group as a whole?
Yeah, we definitely trust him. He won't put us in a bad situation. So wherever he puts us on the field, whatever he does, we know it's for the team. So it's not really anything about us. We just put the team before us. So that's all it is.
Can running backs help create space in any way?
We can definitely help. We can help our linemen by setting up blocks more, by pressing our weakies, our gaps, anything like that. Anything we can do, we can help.
You weren't a teammate of Kevon's last year, but since you got here to campus, and even just since the season started, have you seen progression out of him? And if so, what aspects of his game have really stepped
Kevon,
up?
Kevon, Devin, Noah Kane, Keziah Holmes, Terry Smith, all of them, they all progress every day. We lift weights together, everything. He's just maturing. He's starting to understand football a lot more. As you're younger and as you start to grow older, the game just slows down for you, and I feel like slowing down for him.
Physically, have you ever been around a guy with a build like Kevon? I mean, his catcher.
I wish I had Kevon's body type, but no, I haven't. Yeah, he's a tank.
What's the most impressive part of his physique?
His calves, probably like my thighs.
Yeah.
What was the number one reason that you decided to come to Penn State for 1 year, and has that come to fruition?
Coach Franklin, Coach Sider. I really trust those guys, and Coach Franklin, to me, he's one of the best coaches in college football. He's established, and they established a run game here. And also great team chemistry.
Have you followed the success Baylor's had this year at all? I know you're fully into the program here.
I still have a lot of brothers on that team. A lot of people I still keep in contact with, so we talk here and there. Wish them the best as they do the same for me.
Have you seen a guy as skilled as Jahan is right now, and what are some of the little things that he does, you know, on a daily basis that maybe we wouldn't know?
Jahan for Heisman, but he just works. guy is great at everything he does. He spends extra time working on his hands, his craft, routes, releases, everything like that. So he doesn't cut any corners. So when you get Jahan, you're going to get 100%.
You had mentioned attention to detail as you're setting up a play. Can you elaborate more on just what's going through your mind as you're ready to set up an offensive?
Yeah, so the question was, how can we help our O-line or anything like that? And my response was that we can press our read. So if there's a defender right here, I can run a little farther that way to make him float and maybe just make him miss, just to help our O-line just a little bit.
Regarding the philosophy of running back, some of the criticism is that sometimes you guys don't necessarily appear to be cutting back into the holes and trying to kind of force it. Can you talk me through the philosophy that you guys have of just trying to expand and be more successful?
Well, this isn't high school anymore, so it's going to be very rare if you just get a wide open lane. So we have read keys that we have to follow. We have certain footwork for different plays, and it's all trust. Trust our linemen, trust ourselves, and there's about three different reads on every play, honestly.
How hard is it to make that adjustment? How much do you help the younger guys sort of adjust to the fact that those holes are much slower?
One more time.
How hard is it to adjust from high school where the holes are wide open to college, and how do you help the younger guys, someone who's done it for 5 years?
Like I said with Kevon, it's all about like slowing the game down. So as you grow mature and you start understanding football more, everyone thinks they understand football, but true, I'm pretty sure head coaches learn new things every day, and that's for myself also. So as you start to understand football more, and the game starts to slow down, everything just gets a lot easier and more natural for you.
What's the number one non-physical trait you would give to a running back if you wanted them to be good?
Patience. Patience is key at running back.
Why?
Because if like I said, there's really no open lanes. If you see open lane and you try to take it right away, it's really not open. It's a setup, so patience.
John, Coach Slater told us that this year was really about Kazai Holmes working on himself on the practice field. We haven't really seen him on the game day Saturdays. What are you seeing from Kazai Holmes here?
I see him developing. He's Kaz is pretty big, too. You guys talk about Kevon, but Kaz has a good frame on him himself. Strong guy. He's fast. And he has good feet, everything like that. So Kaz is getting better every day.
What is it like, though? He's a guy who finished last year being pretty involved, a couple touchdowns in the regular season finale, and now to kind of take that seat and have to spend a year learning, what does that require from a young running back?
I honestly think he knows it's probably best for him. He's learning a lot from us, and I think Kaz is going to be a problem next season.
You mentioned you came because of Sider and James. What did they say to convince you to come?
They didn't really have to say much. All they had to do was just give me an offer, and I was coming, and that's what happened.
What part of Penn State has impressed you the most so far?
All I know is Penn State football, so that's all.
A couple more guys.
What's your class routine? Like, are you online or are you?
Nah, I'm in person. I'm taking like 5 classes right now, all in person, no online.
Okay, so you're seeing some of it at least.
Yes. So I go around campus stuff, but you know, I'm just all about Penn State football.
Academically, have you gained something from, obviously you've gained something, but are you pursuing an extra degree or something extra because of this eligibility?
A minor. I'm just doing a minor in communications, arts, and science.
Okay.
So I have a degree in health kinesiology, so I can be a trainer, a coach, or anything like that. I have a degree in that, and I'm just working on a minor in communications.
Do you have a favorite restaurant downtown since you've been?
Honestly, I just... little quick eat, so snap pizza, that's really good. I like customize my own pizza, you know, a little spinach, bacon, all that, but yeah, that's it.
All right, thanks, John.